Watch this video till the end to know all the important dermatology topics asked from FMGE July 2025 examination. Hello dear students, myself Dr. Maddineni Srinivas. Welcome to Crack Derma with DrMSD. So let us begin our discussion. Before that, do hit that like button so that you will remember that you have watched this video. And also remember, this is going to be very, very important for the upcoming NEET PG examination, also the INI exam and also FMGE next session. And very important, from this question paper, the analysis, I can tell you this examiners felt that dermatology is only infections and nothing else. So there were no other questions from core dermatology. That is a little bit disheartening. Students felt that derma was relatively easier and the overall paper was a little bit trickier, and this comment made me also laugh. If you too felt this, please hit that like button. And these were all the topics which were asked. Almost all of them are infections. So let us begin our discussion. 6 year old presenting with papules which are having central umbilication. So this is a buzzword. The answer is going to be option B, molluscum contagiosum virus, pox virus, MCV 1, 2, 3, 4. I hope you remember them. And it is going to present with this kind of a lesion which are centrally umbilicated. Next question, a dentist is presenting with vesicular lesions in the fingers. Always think of the diagnosis possibility of herpetic bitlo. So if you do a Zang smear, we're going to see the multinucleated germ cells. We can confirm the diagnosis now. Yes, it is herpetic bitlo and it is produced by the virus, herpes simplex virus. So it is straightforward question. Next is best description for oral lesion seen in Kaposi sarcoma. Remember dear students, Kaposi sarcoma is associated with human herpes virus number 8. This was a NEET question. So you need to also know the previous year questions of the NEET. So if you see here, this is a Kaposi sarcoma, the oral cavity taken from NEJM. And so what is the color you are able to see? It is purple colored lesions which are going to see. The answer is going to be option D, purple colored elevated lesions. Yes. Next. Fever is there, forest trip history is there, and there is a black eschar formed over the abdomen. So examiner is asking what is the drug of choice. So if you have thought of the diagnosis as a scrub typhus, your diagnosis is absolutely correct, and the drug is going to be tetracycline group doxycycline. Okay. Next, the examiner has asked hypersensitivity reaction, Jell-and-Coombs hypersensitivity reaction, which is seen in the BT leprosy. So I hope you remember that in BT leprosy, patients are going to get type 1 lepra reaction. And if you remember, 1 plus 4 is equals to 5, and type 2 lepra reaction is associated with, yes, type 3 hypersensitivity, Jell-and-Coombs. So it is going to be the total 5. So answer here is going to be, because it is type 1 lepra reaction, which is commonly seen in BT leprosy. So yes, it is going to be type 4 hypersensitivity reaction, Jell-and-Coombs hypersensitivity reaction type 4. Next is this question, pediatric OPD, 4-year-old child coming with vesicular lesions of the palms, soles and the oral mucosal involvement. And some students told that even image was given. So with all these clues, if you have thought the diagnosis as hand, foot, mouth, this is absolutely correct diagnosis. And the organism is going to be Coxsackie A16. And if the examiner has given Coxsackie A6 or enterovirus 72, they can also be the correct answer. Next is a diabetic patient. There are whitish blocks present. So you may be confused with oral hairy leukoplakia or candida. So that's the reason why examiner gave that it is a budding yeast and pseudo hyphae. So the diagnosis is straight away candida. And the culture medium which we can use in these patients is seborrheic dextrose agar, SDA medium. Okay. So if it was oral hairy leukoplakia, the plaque would have been non-scrapable and it is associated with Epstein-Barr virus, usually seen in immunocompromised individuals. I hope you remember all these points. Next is a woman tampon. So these are the clues which are sufficient: high grade fever, hypotension, and also diffuse rash in the skin. So all this point towards the diagnosis of toxic shock syndrome. Next is a young patient. There are dark brown to black macules over the lips and the mucosa, and there is hematomatous polyps associated. I hope all of you have answered it, Peutz-Jeghers syndrome. And what are these macules? These are the mucosal lentigens which can be seen, as you are able to see in this picture, and these are the hematomatous polyps. Next is a factual question from pathology. fibrillin gene mutation, it is seen in the Marfan syndrome. HPV infection, the examiner got bored asking all the genital lesions associated with human papillomavirus. So now they have given something different, Hatke. So remember, it is oropharyngeal cancer, which can be most commonly associated with human papillomaviral infection. So my suggestion for all the FMG warriors, so you have worked hard, you have given the exam, so now chill and relax. You can use any of these OTT series. For the NEET warriors, my suggestion would be continue your preparation. You are very close to the examination, so you are going to study. Don't worry, you may feel that you are dying during this last 2 days, but just stick on to your revision notes and volatile topics, and you are going to do awesome in the examination. And we are going to meet on the recall session for the NEET examination also. So hit that like button, dear students, if this video was helpful, and also comment any type of difference which you felt from the actual exam or any other topics which are asked in the actual exam in the comment section. And also do subscribe to this channel so that you are going to be updated dermatologically. Thank you so much. Happy learning. Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanam Sarvejana Sugina Bhavantu.